You guys, God forbid, but if you come across the bad ones, to be honest, they will get in your space. It's normal. They will get in your space. They will annoy you. You feel like fighting. They might dirty up the place. They might not clean after themselves. Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, my name is Adebiju. Thank you for stopping by, and please do not forget to subscribe. So today we're talking about shared apartments. So this video is going to be in two parts. This first one is going to talk about the worst parts. Then the second part is going to talk about the good parts of staying in a shared accommodation. I mean, because there is a good and the bad side of everything. So let's get started, you guys. First thing is, what is a shared accommodation? And I'm starting this way because somebody asked me that. How much am I paying for my rent? I said 390. Then the person goes on to say, how much, like, how many rooms is that 390? I'm like, this is not what is it is not what it is in Nigeria. That 390 will give you like a bigger space or something. So the 390 I'm paying in my, you guys can see the shape of my room, right? It is small. So the 390 I'm paying now is for my room. So let me just explain what shared accommodation is for you guys. So you guys, what is a shared accommodation or a shared apartment? So a shared accommodation basically is that you're sharing space or the house with people you do not know, with strangers. And in some cases, you might know the person or the people you're sharing the house with. Maybe you guys took the house together or something. So most shared accommodations that I have seen, you guys, they are usually like four people in a house, or five people in a house, or six people in a house. Then in these houses, they are usually like general spaces. So they're usually like general spaces, and those general spaces include the toilets or the toilets. It depends, toilet or the toilets, the kitchen, the sitting or the dining area. So those places, everybody in the house has access to it. Everybody like can use it. It is for everybody. Then everybody now has their own rooms separately. That is your own personal space. So let me go back again. Some of these houses, for instance, in a four shared apartment, sometimes they're usually like just one toilet. So all of you four will be using just one toilet. In some of the five too, you will see just one toilet. But thank God, my own, we have two toilets. And so two people are using one and three people are using one, so like that's fine. And to be honest, I don't think everybody can want to use the toilet at the same time. I don't know if that's possible. So that's another thing. So you guys are usually responsible for the cleaning of your house, except it is stated otherwise in your contract that there will be a cleaner coming to clean your house. For instance, in my own house now, there's a cleaner that comes to clean our house. At the beginning, it was very consistent, but later on, it wasn't that consistent again. I had to like go and meet the agency that you guys see, oh, this is what's happening, and they fixed it. So it's your right to do the needful. So that is basically like the summary of shared accommodation. So with this picture I've painted for you now, imagine living with four people, sharing the kitchen with them, sharing the toilets with them, and all these things. Definitely people will get into your spaces. You in your space, rather, you will get angry, you will be pissed. Like it's just normal. It's just normal because you're sharing everything with them, especially if you're not used to this type of lifestyle. And I forgot to mention, you guys, and the kitchen sometimes in some places have the kitchen in some places have a bigger fridge where everybody also shares. That's another thing you people will share. People will share the fridge and the freezer. You people will share the cabinets in the kitchen. That's another thing you guys are going to share, because you will have to like pick your own space in the kitchen, pick your own space in the fridge and the freezer. Like, okay, that's where we did it in my own house, because we have a big storage. So everybody had to like, this is your side, this is my side, this is your side. It's not as if we still don't use like every other person's side, but we just know that this place so is for this person, this place so saw this person. So let's move on to, maybe I will have to do another video on shared accommodation, but so let's move on to like the worst parts of living with people. You guys, I wrote a list down and I really wanted to do this video with my friends, but nobody wants to come and cast their housemates. So I will be doing the casting on their behalf. And you guys, please, breaking transmission, if you know anybody that is looking for a shared apartment in all very close to school, please tell them to send me a DM on Instagram or an email. I'm going to reply. You guys, so let's start. The very first thing on my list is dirtiness, uncleanliness, any adjective you have for it. Basically, this is something you should expect in a shared apartment. Like, some people are dirty. Some people are very, very dirty. Like, for me, I hate when the kitchen is dirty. Like, I dislike it with passion. So I always like it like when the kitchen is clean. So someone was telling me that in your own house, like that, for instance, when they first of all moved into the house, that when they finish eating, they don't used to wash the plates. So they will drop the plates. The next person to eat, they will drop the plates. The third person to eat, they will drop the plates. I think there is one person in the house that does not just like seeing plates at the sink. So that one will come, that one will wash the plates. So it now became a pattern. They will eat, they will drop, they will eat, they will drop, because they knew that somebody was going to wash it. So they kept doing that. So it now got to a point that I think the person got tired and was like, what's all this nonsense now? You should please clean up after yourself. Might not even be plates, it might be toilets, it might be some people who just eat the dining area, the wrap that they used to eat. They can just choose to say, oh, this place looks like bean, let me drop it here. They will just like, just they just like messy looking place, or they just don't know how to clean up after doing anything in the toilets, in the kitchen. Like, they will just leave it dirty. Like, dirty is cute for them. So they just leave it dirty. Some people just like it like that. So imagine this type of thing, and you're somebody that, like me now, if I want to cook, I always make sure like the surface of the hob is clean, everywhere around is clean. So imagine if you now get down to that kind of kitchen now, and you're about to start cooking, and you see that kind of nonsense, you will be provoked, honestly, and you will just have to clean it. They might not even be around to even say, oh, you were the one that did. And how would you even know the person that even messed up the place? Because when you ask, everybody will say it's not them. Nobody's going to say, oh, it is me. Nobody will say it's me. So you now be looking like the one that complains too much, that kind of thing. By the way, I'm the one that complains too much in my house. So like they give me that look. So before I even continue, there was this apartment I was meant to, the very first one I viewed before I came to view this one. You guys, when I got to the house and I saw them sweeping out, I think the cleaner there was cleaning the house, and I saw her sweeping the things she was sweeping out. In my head, I was like, where did they pour dustbin on the floor and she's sweeping it out? Or like, what is this? What is going on? Apparently, she was cleaning the dining area. And the room I was even meant to take was downstairs. So is that my room that will be close to all this nonsense? That was like the beginning of me saying, see, I don't want this house. And it was even far from school. So thank God I even went to view the house. I knew that, oh, the people living there, we will not be able to tolerate ourselves. We will not be able to tolerate ourselves. It wasn't going to work. So I was like, I don't want this one. And it was even far from school. So the next thing is thin wall. So this is my room, like I said. Then the next room beside me is another person's room, but she's not in my house. I don't know if you guys get it. It's another apartment entirely. So I can hear when that auntie is on call, and she's Yoruba. So basically, she's giving me gist, and sometimes when I'm sleeping and I hear her voice, it affects me. Like, I'll be like, okay, let's finish this call, then we can go to sleep, that kind of thing. But if I'm already asleep, you can't wake me up, or except the noise is very loud. So like the so if a room is close to you, you should expect that you will hear disturbance from the next person. That is some like it's not even only shared apartment. This is like everywhere in the UK. Like they have thin wall. There was this apartment we went to check with one of my friends, and after checking, we asked the man that, oh, what else is wrong with this house? The man was like, the wall is very light, like it's very thin. I don't know if it's plywood they used to separate the house. Like the wall is very thin. So it was like one day at night, he was hearing somebody playing game, war, like that. So he was like, ah, my daughter is playing game by this time of the night. He was already tiptoeing to go and meet the girl. He now got to the room, he now realized that the girl was about to go and beat is sleeping. He was their neighbor that was playing game and making noise. So like expect to hear sounds from the other room. That's like a norm. So imagine if you have a noisy roommate. Thank God for me, this person is not my, she's not my, what's it called? She's not my flatmate. Our house is even across the next house, not even, she's not staying in my own house. So another thing she expects is a thin wall. Moving on to the next, it is noise, you guys. Noise. You might have a flatmate that is the life of the party, that likes to blast music, that likes to make noise that is very loud, that you think they swallowed speaker. And imagine if you're a quiet person, you're reserved, you're not used to that type of thing. If a person should do it the first time, you like, okay, yeah. Person should do the second time, okay. If he's coming and coming and coming and coming again, you'll be like, what is this? Like, why are you doing this? Like, why are you making noise? That's another thing that will be like, what's wrong with you? Stop it. But the way you say it, the way you approach it, might cause fight and things like that. So that's another thing you should also look out for, noise. If you don't like noise, go and collect house on your own. Go and collect house on your own. Like sometimes I might be upstairs and my other flatmates are gisting downstairs and I'm trying to do something. Will I tell them to shut up? No. I will either choose to go to library and do my work or go downstairs and gist with them. So you have to find a way to figure out these things. So the next thing is using your things slash spoiling your things. So we went for one of my friend's birthday party, and most times you can see everybody's kitchen. Then when we got to their kitchen, I saw like four bottles of dishwashing liquid. I was not like, ah, why do you people have four dishwashing liquid? She was like, oh, that sure, I know that there are four in the house and everybody has their own dishwashing liquid. I'm like, you don't mean it. Like in my own house, so is everybody's is now like now is my own dishwashing liquid we are using. If my own should finish and the next person will buy. And like this is like the first time I'm even buying soap in the house. But okay, I will talk about that one in the second part of this video. So I was so surprised to see that they couldn't share like dishwashing liquid, so everybody had to buy their own soap so that there will be no fights. So imagine in that kind of place that you're the only one that has soap, everybody will use your own. And let's say you don't like people using your things, you're going to get angry, you're going to shout. Another thing that I saw that was funny was in another one of two different people's house. They cooked and they kept their food inside the cabinet. And I'm like, why are you putting your pots with the food inside the cabinet? Like, what was that? They're like, oh, that they have to carry it away because of their flatmates. I'm like, do they steal food too? I'm like, do they steal food too? Like, I'm really grateful for the type of flatmate I have, because when I start hearing people's stories, I'm like, what is wrong with you people? Like, what is your problem? So like they had to put their food in what's it called? in the cabinets because they don't want people to use to take their food. Or some people in some houses say they don't even share their pots. So imagine you having to start complaining that, oh, this person is using my pots, this person, like, people expect that people will use your things. If not, you will get angry, like you will get pissed. And spoiling your things, definitely, if they are using your things, they might not handle it with as much care as you're going to handle it, so they might definitely spoil your things. I think one day I was downstairs and I saw somebody scratching one of my pots with iron spoon. Like me, like, I'm easy going basically, so far the place is not dirty. I saw someone scratching my pots with iron pot, with iron spoon, and I was like, which pot are you scratching? It's my pot. It's a non-stick pan. My brother is a non-stick pan. You don't use iron spoon inside non-stick pan. He was like, oh, you did not know, blah blah blah. So after that, I saw someone else do the same thing again. I'm like, you know what, everybody use spoon in the pots if you want to use the pots. There is no need. If I did not see it, I wouldn't have known that. Okay, I would have known because I would have seen the scratches on the pots. Do you get? So, like, to me, that wasn't an issue, honestly, because the pots. Do you get? But then the other person involved, the way we both handled it, it was like there was no issue. We just talked about it, and it was like, oh, he didn't know that he's a guy, so I understand. He didn't know that this, that iron pan, non-stick pan, you don't use spoon, that, sorry, blah blah blah. And that was it. Like, that was it, you guys. The next thing is not being helpful. You guys, like, I think I've told the people before that in this UK, like, everything is letters, 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 letters. Some people, like, so they will bring your letter to your house. If you apply for anything online that needs to be delivered to you, that is a document, they would come and deliver it to your house, and they will pass it through your door. It's going to come in form of a letter. Some of your classmates will even see your letter there and step on it. What, imagine if it's something like somebody's DBS or somebody's very important documents, and you saw that they brought the letter, and your classmate's name would definitely be written on it. But some people would leave it there, step on it, pass. So just imagine, or just imagine, like, but like in my own house, okay, the other part, sorry, this one is getting too long. So the next thing is tiny compartment and storage. You guys, in some shared apartments that I've seen, or if you see the fridge, if you see the fridge in the house, you'll be like, what is this? The fridge and the freezer, very tiny, usually very tiny, so that way you can't even store things. This one is not even about people now. You can't even store things you have, so you guys might have to buy your own fridge or freezer. I now imagine if there is no space in the house. So that would affect the way you'll be going to buy your grocery and all those things. So, like, some of these apartments usually have tiny storage. So you have to look for an alternative. As by storage, I mean like the fridge and freezer basically. So you might have to, like, find another way to, like, store your things. Then the last part is, like, to be honest, I don't have so many things to say. So the last part is they might not be your friends. Like, you guys, the apartment I used to stay at Grimsby, we were four in the house. I don't know the remaining three. I only knew one, and that was because we jammed in the kitchen. And that was because, like, we jammed ourselves in the kitchen. The other woman, you know, I said, like, the wall is thin. So, like, this one, I legit see her conversation, and we were in the same house together. So I knew her voice, but I did not know her face. So how I even knew her face was I went out to catch the bus. Then she also came out to, like, she came out to meet me at the bus station, like, minutes later. Then she was on phones, and her voice was very loud. This one, she's also a Yoruba woman. Her voice was very loud. That was, I was like, oh, so this is my classmate. So, like, they might not even be your friend. Like, you guys are just living in the house together. This one, they were not even dirty. It was just that they were not dirty. But there was nothing that would make all of us sit down together and say we want to gist. Nothing, absolutely nothing. Like, They are not your friends, you are not their friend. You people are just living in the same house, nothing concern them concern you. So mind your business. And the last one, imagine if you're the type of person that doesn't like meeting strangers. You guys, me, I'm guilty of this, and I know I'm guilty of this because I know a lot of people, and my house is very close to the school, so sometimes my friend will just come to the house. So imagine if you don't like meeting people, you can just see a stranger in your house the next minute. Somebody might just be in your sharing space. Like, let's say now you that in your house used to wear singlet and tights, or used to cover your hair, you're a Muslim or something, and you're just inside your house and you're like, let me just remove my scarf or something, and the next thing you are seeing a man in your parlor. Like, what is this now? Like, why? So you might end up meeting like strangers in your house. And the truth is, my flatmates also bring like their friends to the house, and most cases, I can talk to anybody, we can have any conversation together basically. So the conversation will just flow. But if you're somebody that doesn't like to see people around your space, sorry, your flatmates might be life of the party. You might know a lot of people that will just want to say hi. But funny thing is, it is what it is, you guys. So the last thing I'm going to say is this: irrespective of all these things that might provoke you, might annoy you, I think you should know a way and find a way that you guys can always tolerate each other. Like, find a way to like talk to each other. And I feel like the advantages of shared accommodation are actually more than the disadvantages. So there is that as well. So these are things you should expect living with people. It's normal. It's normal. And yes, if you watch up until now, thank you very much for watching. And please, I'm going to upload part 2 of this video, so please do not miss it. Thank you. Bye.